What's going on, guys? My name is Stanczak, and in this video in particular, I'm going to be showing you how you guys can save a bunch of time by utilizing the align feature in PowerPoint. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, so in this example, I just have a dark forest background, three icons, three pieces of text, and then three boxes. So I'm going to show you how you can align these super quickly. So first, this is what most people do is, so let's say you create your box, then people made their text, they try to line it up, and they look for those red lines, and there we go, now it's lined up. Then what they do next is sometimes they'll go here, try to line this up with the next box, bring this text in, and try to make sure this is centered, and it can be super finicky. So instead of doing that method, here's what you guys can do. So let me undo this real quick. Put these back. Let's say you put these boxes down. It doesn't even matter where they're located. They could be up there. Click on all three. Go to arrange, align, align middle. So now they're all aligned in the middle. Now, let's say you want them to be proportionally staggered between each other. What you can do is the old school method of trying to line it up. But if you want them to be for sure guaranteed spaced in between each other, you can go here, align, and then distribute horizontally, which we'll do this way instead of this way. And now they're going to be evenly spread out amongst each other. Now for this text, let's say I'm bringing this in and I want it in the box. I don't even have to worry about how it's going to be aligned because I'll show you guys in a second. Now I want all this text to be aligned in the center and middle of these boxes. So if I highlight both of them, then go to align and I can do center and then I can do middle. And now that text is going to be perfectly aligned in that box. Next, I can do it for this same one as well. Align, middle, align, center. And you're going to see that I actually move this entire box a little bit, but that's okay. I'll show you guys how to fix that in a little bit. And then what you can do is you can do the same thing for this third one. Go to align, middle, and then align, go to center. All right. Now the box is shifted a little bit. So how to fix that? What you can do is you can make sure these are all grouped. Control G, Control G, Control G. Now you can click on each one of these. Go here to arrange. You can do align middle just to make sure they're still aligned correctly. And then you can go align and do distribute horizontally. All right. And now you have all of them evenly spaced out and spaced out horizontally. Now let's say you want these to be perfectly in the center of the slide. Here's what you can do next. You can highlight all of them, Control G to copy the entire thing, go here to align, go here to center. So now it's centered on the slide. Then what you can do is you can go here to arrange, align, middle. And now that is the exact center and middle of the slide. All right, now here we have our icons. So obviously you can try to line them up with this red line, which is not the worst thing to do. But if you are OCD and you just want to make sure that they are aligned properly, here's what you can do. I'm going to ungroup this large grouping. I'm going to make sure that these two objects are aligned properly. Just do align center. Same with this one, align center. And then this one as well, align center. All right, so now all these objects are aligned center with each one of these boxes, but let's say there's an example like this where they're not all aligned in the middle. What you can do is you can click on this object, this one, and this one. You can go here to arrange, align, middle. So now they're all arranged evenly across the line and they're distributed vertically. You can obviously resize them if you do control shift, hold that down and click on the edge of the box. You can increase proportionally the shape. And then there you go. You're evenly distributed. It's perfectly aligned. You don't have to get too OCD about it. You don't have to like try to guess exactly where this red line is and line it up. Obviously, that is a feature that you guys can do, but this is a quick way to align your slides without having to really focus on making sure it's perfectly aligned. All right, so now that we have it perfectly aligned, I want to show you guys a couple more examples just to make sure you guys really understand this feature. So let's say you have these three boxes. And you actually want them distributed evenly vertically. All you have to do is move these icons to the side for now. You can move this up, and then move this one down. And then if you go here to arrange, align, distribute vertically. Now they're going to be evenly distributed vertically. What I recommend is getting it as close as possible to what you actually want. It doesn't have to be perfect. And that way it's going to distribute vertically a little bit closer to each other. All right. And then what you can do is since they're not aligned centered, you go arrange, align, center. And now you got them centered and distributed evenly vertically. Obviously, if you want them a little closer, feel free to move them a little closer like this. And then just to make sure they're evenly distributed, you could go here to distribute vertically. And then you could also do the same thing for these icons. So that is how you can distribute it vertically. Let's say you want to align everything to the left. So we're just going to pretend that they're all wonky like this, and you want them all to be lined up with this left side right here. You can just do arrange, line left, and now they're all going to be hugging that left side. Now keep in mind that if this object is bigger than the other ones, they're not going to be centered perfectly, but they will all be shifted to the left perfectly and aligned on this side. So that's also a helpful tool to know as well. All right, so that is the gist of using the Align tool. It's a very powerful tool, and there's a bunch of different options that you can pick here as well. I just showed you as many as I possibly could in this video, just to keep it nice, short, and sweet. But there's other options here as well if you'd like to use them. I hope you guys found this helpful. If you did like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And also, if you could subscribe to this channel, I greatly appreciate the support. Also, if you are interested in learning more about PowerPoint, I'm offering a PowerPoint course on Udemy. There's a 90% discount code in the description below, so feel free to check out that link. Also, let me know in the comments what you guys are looking for next. So without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. Thanks.